Senator Sherwin Gatchalian is calling on the IATF to start vaccinating those in the A4 priority group. These are essential workers in the fields of transportation, construction, and food manufacturing, and others. To discuss this further, we now have Senator Nguyen himself over the phone. Good afternoon, Senator. Thanks for joining us today. On Twitter, you said that only 19% of senior citizens came in for vaccination in the city of Valenzuela. Is this the reason why you want to bump up all A4s?
Good afternoon, Sean, and good afternoon to our listeners. After vaccinating the A1, A2, A3 in Valenzuela, we simultaneously gathered statistics and we found out that only 20% of our senior citizens are willing to be vaccinated. In fact, we even went to the extent of going house to house to give them their schedules so that they will know when to come and get their vaccination. But only 20% responded. The 80% actually said no. In fact, some of them even said that ang gusto nila ayuda, hindi bakuna. So vaccine hesitation is real and it's becoming a problem in the rollout of vaccines in the local government units. So we cannot wait for the A2 and A3s to change their mind. So the proposal here is to bump up the A4s because a lot of A4s are willing and ready to get their vaccines and even open it up to the general public as soon as the A4s are completely vaccinated.
All right. There is logic in your suggestion, Senator. How about the IATF? Were they amenable to your recommendation? Did they say they would take it up or has this been or maybe already for discussion?
We are in constant communication with the IATF. In fact, in fairness to them, they've been very responsive to the vaccination rollout. If you remember last April, the A4s were only limited to very few sectors, but they opened it up to members of the media, members of the education sector, members of the government sector, and liberalized it basically to other sectors. So in that sense, we have already echoed, not only me, no, but also other senators have already echoed their sentiments towards expanding it immediately, no, to A4s and subsequently immediately to the general public.
All right, so what that means, Senator, is that there is supply available if you want to bump it up. How are we doing on matters of supply? Can you shed some light on that?
Correct. You're absolutely correct. There are a lot of supplies, and supplies are constantly coming right now. From our information, there are about 2 million doses in the warehouses right now, and there are 15 million more coming in from various sources, including COVAX and including the ones that we bought. So in the next few weeks, we'll have approximately about 70 to 20 million doses. But if we keep on waiting for the A2s and the A3s to change their minds, those vaccines run a risk of expiring because some of the vaccines, for example, AstraZeneca, it's going to expire around June, sometime June. So with the present expiration date, we cannot wait for that. No, so in other words, we have to vaccinate as many as possible. And those who are willing, we have to immediately give it to them.
All right. And you already mentioned that some of your fellow senators are actually in agreement with the priority group move, or A4 priority group being moved up already. Now, as lawmakers, is there anything you can do beyond the recommendation?
Right now, what we are constantly doing is to communicate with the IATF, and General Galvez has been very, very accessible to the senators and very transparent in terms of the rollout, and we commend them for that. So the immediate action should be a revision of the policy allowing A4s to be vaccinated. And this is important, Sean. Let me emphasize that because the local government units, the mayors are listening to the IATF. They get their instructions from the IATF and the DOH. So if there are no clear instructions, the mayors will not move. And we all know that the rollout is in the hands of the mayors.